We have a situation with Christiana.
Who's Christiana?
Do you pay any attention to your job at all, Christiana Marco? She's the model for our fall pre-show.
Okay, what's the problem, Maxie?
Apparently, she just threw a water bottle at her dresser.
Well, she's probably hungry. Have someone give her a cheeseburger. She'll be fine.
Really? That is your solution? Do you know anything about artists or how they work?
Christiana Marcos is not an artist. She is an underfed, spoiled, rotten model who should get down on her knees and thank God every day she's getting paid a flipping fortune to have her stupid picture taken in overpriced clothes and get over herself.
I can't believe I'm stuck in this office with you. Let me see that call sheet. See this right.
Greetings, fun ones. See, my favorite friends are functioning as a well-oiled, lovely, two-headed machine. You look especially bright today. Might the jackal assume you've suffered no ill effects from the night we spent together?
I'm sorry, what did you just say? Hey! Hi, Trips.
Hey. Hey. What have you done?
I don't know. I don't know if it's your hair or did you do something different with your hair, your shirt. I like it. It's kind of hot. Don't you think? I'm sorry. We really need to backtrack. Did I hear you say you spent the night with Maxie?
Oh, that must suck being you. Every single guy you think of as your own personal property eventually finds their way to little me.
One question, Spinelli. Why?
Maximista was kind enough to tend to the jackal at her place of residence after Mr. Corinthoster slammed my head there into that structure.
Wait, attacked you? Sonny is a barbarian. Of course, Spinelli didn't have time to react, much less defend himself. Not that he could.
No, look, apparently Spinelli gave some unasked for advice to Sonny about Morgan.
Oh, well, that makes sense.
Oh, so you're condoning what Sonny
did. No, I am just saying, obviously after what happened to Michael, Sonny's kids are a hot button right now, so... Especially if Spinelli, however unintentionally, is implying that Sonny's not good for his kids or something.
This doesn't excuse the fact that Sonny rammed Spinelli's head into a wall.
Your modesty is confusing your friends. I have no doubt that you could have obviously defended yourself, but out of pure obligation to Sonny, you stayed quiet because of his grief.
Exactly. Right? Jackal deeply respects the
pain. No, that's not how it happened at all. Sonny attacked and Spinelli was paralyzed.
Spinelli is so naturally sweet, it's easy to miss the tough guy underneath. I mean, he can totally handle himself. I've seen him in action. Remember when we were being chased by Alex's dogs? And it was me, you, and Jason, and, well, whatever. Anyways, he was nothing short of incredible.
Hey, you don't have to convince me that Spinelli rocks. His cyber skills are, like, life-changing. I know exactly why Jason keeps him on the payroll. Who cares if Spinelli is useless in a fight? I mean, that's what they keep Jason around for, anyway. All the dangerous stuff.
The jackal continues to learn from the master. Self-defense sessions are not out of the question.
Yeah, well, as long as Jason doesn't let you anywhere near his gun. Remember last summer you shot yourself in the foot? Nobody wants that situation.
Oh. Hop to ladies. I need updates on the writers for the premiere issue.
Thank you. Oh, Smiley. Should I be worried?
No, I'm here merely in a social capacity.
Oh, good. Well, now I'm going to have to ask you to leave. We're not having a party. And is there something I can help you with?
Yeah, I just came to see... the place. My mother told me all about the Alexis Davis.
Sam!
Yes!
Yes.
You know what? Under any other circumstances, I would love to make...
No, please. I completely understand. You're busy. Everyone's busy. We are, too. We have got a ton of things to do. So,
thanks.
Bye. Okay. So, where were we, ladies?
Printing house rejected our PC account.
Oh, yeah. Probably because you forgot to send them a check last month. Maybe too busy chasing Johnny. Don't worry, I took care of it. We're going to have a new account within the hour.
Did you tell Kate?
No, I saved your sorry butt. But don't, for one second, think that I'll be making that a habit.
Thank you. You must be getting pretty desperate, by the way.
Meaning?
Did you buy more?
Three hole punch. Yes, I stocked up this morning.
Perfect. Why am I desperate?
Here's case schedule for the week.
Why else would you drive poor unsuspecting Spinelli to your house and trap him in your disgusting bed overnight? You're afraid that he's seeing you for the manipulative slut that you are, so you're using sex the one thing that you are good at.
Thanks, the schedule looks good. And... I'm calling Sour Grapes. I think you're a jealous loser because you can't stand that Spinelli and I are closer than the two of you ever were. You must be here for Kate.
Oh, I'll let her know.
She's expecting me. I called her.
Oh. be the most selfish creature on the face of the planet.
Who's talking?
If you want to be the center of Spinelli's universe, hand me that letter. And have your big bad mobster romance at the same time, let's experiment. Try not to think about yourself for 1 second. I know it's probably impossible, but think about Spinelli.
I need Gretchen's fax number.
You know, you should really try putting this in your Rolodex. Why should Spinelli have to sit on the sidelines and watch while you make a fool of yourself for Johnny when everyone knows that whatever you think you have with him clearly is doomed? Where are the messengers with those mock-ups?
Stuck in traffic on his way. You know what? I'll give you some credit. You are an expert on a lot of things.
Thank you.
Like crying on cue, rolling over on your back. Let's not forget sucking up to Kate. But you know absolutely zero about me and Johnny. In fact, you know nothing about relationships.
I'll tell you one thing I do know for sure. Now that Johnny's already had you, shouldn't be too hard to get him to break up with you.
What is your bizarre obsession over the men in my life? You trashed my brother, you seduced Logan, God knows what you did with Spinelli, and now you're hoping that Johnny will break up with me. Who's next, my dad? Oh, I'm not against dating an older man. You are revolting, and I swear to God, Maxie, if you go anywhere near my father, I will break you.
Oh, that could be interesting. I'd do it just to hear you call me stepmom. On the other hand, I could just take Johnny away from you.
You're delusional.
You think?
Mm-hmm.
Hold that thought. Johnny! Hi, it's Maxie. I'm good, how are you? I'm, at the office. I needed to settle something with you. Do you think you could come over here right now? Great, I'll see you soon. Bye. Kate, Christiana just walked out of the photo shoot.
Oh, skinny bitch.
I'm so glad you got here so fast. Thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
I didn't realize Maxie had so much influence over you.
I was hoping you would be here, and you are. I don't have any complaints. What can I do for you?
Pay up. Remember when I covered for Lulu the day she blew off work just because you asked me to?
I remember.
Or you said you'd owe me, and I'm ready to collect.
Sure, whatever you want.
I'm so glad you said that. Now, I can't wait to go to Federico's party in Manhattan next Friday with you on my arm.